My name is Angel Sanchez, and I used to have a life just like yours. Back before the world as we knew it came to an end. It was the day before my 23rd birthday when the aliens arrived. They called themselves Catteni, and they were savage enemies. They showed us no mercy, and they played for keeps. Heard on the radio that the United Nations had signed a truce with the Catteni. It was just a nice way of saying total surrender. Then things really went to hell. They started herding us into refugee camps. I don't know what happened to my family, but that's what happened to me. Millions of other people just vanished. No one knows where they went, but a lot of us look up at the sky and wonder. Now, most of the human race is under alien control, or collaborating with the Catteni in hopes of receiving a little better treatment. The alternative, the unknown, is just too terrible for most people to contemplate. The only exceptions are scavengers who fled the Catteni. And the resistance, a collection of freedom fighters and rebels carrying on the struggle in hopes of one day freeing Earth from alien rule. The odds are against them, but it doesn't matter. They're all we've got. This is their story. This is my story. This is a story of the human race's last desperate fight for freedom. When I woke up this morning, I found a note someone had left for me. It was on plain white paper. And it read,
"Hello, Angel. You don't know me, but I know you. My friends and I have been watching you for some time, and we're rather impressed with the way you handle yourself. We could use someone like you, if you're interested in maybe helping show the Catteni whose planet this really is. Mind you, it's not going to be easy, but if you think you're up to it, there's a place in the Resistance waiting for you. Unfortunately, we can't just break into the refugee camp and induct you there. You've got to come to us. Your first goal is to get out of the camp itself without alerting the peacekeepers. If you can do that, further instructions will be waiting for you outside. Good luck, Angel. You're going to need it."
At the bottom of the note was a symbol for the Resistance. It could be a trap, but I can't just sit around here and rot. Not anymore. I should make a point of checking my journal after talking to people. Looking at the map frequently is also a good idea, as it'll let me know where I am and where I should be going.
This place is a zoo with humans on the inside.
Why do you say that?
We're caged in here. There's no way out except feet first.
Maybe someone should do something about that.
Yeah, that would be nice. The Resistance is trying, I hear, but it's not like they're doing too well. I mean, if they were, we wouldn't still be herded in here.
Have you heard anything about what it's like outside?
All I know is that I don't know what's out there, whether it's more aliens, the Resistance, or whatever. I do know that in here stinks, though. Good night.
Leave me alone!
Angel, so good to see you again.
I'm not sure. I got a note from a stranger, and I'm trying to figure out what to do about it.
It's not a note from a young man, is it?
You know there's no time for that. Besides, since I lost Dennis, I haven't exactly been looking.
I forgot. You lost your young man in the invasion. I'm sorry, dear. I take it that it's from someone who's not a gentleman?
It's from the Resistance. They seem to want me to escape and join up with them.
Well, that changes things, my dear. If this is real, and I suspect it is. You should ask yourself if you're ready to do that sort of thing. It's dangerous out there. Much more dangerous than it is in the camp. But I've seen you, Angel. You're not happy here. You're angry at the Catteni, and you want to fight back. This might be your chance.
I need a way out, Miriam.
That could be difficult, Angel. The Catteni have sealed this place up tight. Then again, they don't know everything, do they?
But you do. I've seen you trading in fresh fruit, Miriam. You must know how to get outside, or know someone who does.
You're an observant one. Yes, I do know people on the outside. I trade with them on occasion, but not often. I also have a brother living with the scavengers under the city. His name is Lawrence, and I haven't seen him in 6 months.
But you must have escaped and seen him, right? You have to know how to get out of here.
I can't tell you how to escape, Angel. The world comes to me. I don't go to it. But talk to Seamus if you want to leave and take this for him. He's not a greedy man, but he'll want something for his help. You'll be able to find him in the collaborators' wing this time of night. He claims they need more cleaning, if you can believe that.
But you're going to stay here?
I'm not going anywhere, Angel. This is my place. But if you decide it's your place to go, I want you to take this. Find my brother if you can and give him this. Something tells me you'll be seeing him soon.
I should check my inventory now. Maybe I can talk to him and learn a few things.
Good evening, miss. It's a pleasant night, isn't it?
Are you Seamus?
That's the way it always is, isn't it? There's no manners anymore, no courtesy. Yes, I'm Seamus. Seamus Reardon, and you're Miss Angel Sanchez, and you live out of the old bookstore with the Tolliver family, the Hernandez brothers, and 9 or 10 other folks. Am I right?
That's amazing. How did you know?
My dear Miss Sanchez, I have to know an awful lot in my line of work. What is that line of work, you ask? Why, it's keeping this place going. If you were to rely on that lot over there in the movie theater, or their big furry friends, the roof would have fallen down 8 months ago. You can count on that. The Catteni, at least, are smart enough to let me go about my business. It saves them trouble in the end.
But you don't work for the peacekeepers, right?
Let's just say there are things that I do the lads in the funny hats would disapprove of if they knew, so I take care not to tell them. I'm no friend of the Catteni, though. You walk around this place like I have, Angel, and you'll get the sense that it can't go on like this for too much longer. There are too many people in too little space, and not enough food or medicine to go around.
I see. You've given me a lot to think about. I'll be back in a bit.
I'll be here. There's always work to do. Have no fear. I see you're back again. What do you have to say for yourself?
This place is just too quiet, don't you think?
Trust me, lass. You're not going to want to see this place when certain folks get riled up. I'm sure it won't be pretty. The way to deal with things here, if you want them done, is fast and quiet.
Things like Miriam smuggling?
You know about that, do you? Well, let's just say that Miriam's an old and dear friend, and she's got her wits about her. She sent you to me, didn't she? No doubt she wants me to help you escape. Well, I can tell you something about that. Escaping is easy. Escaping the right way, so that the peacekeepers don't come looking for you and tear through a dozen of your neighbors, that's hard. Are you ready to take that risk?
You're right on the money. So can you help me, for Miriam's sake, if not mine?
I might be able to help you. I won't ask for much in exchange, either. I get the sense that you're going to be more important in all this than I am before it's over. But I can't go giving away my help for free, either, else everyone and their brother will be asking me, and sooner or later, someone will make a slip. No, it has to be this way.
I'm not sure I want to deal with someone so mercenary.
Good luck in finding anyone else. Come back if you change your mind. I see you're back again. What do you have to say for yourself?
Miriam gave me something for you. Will this get me your help?
A bottle of ammonia, is it? Miriam's got a sense of humor. She's a smart woman, she is, and make no mistake about that. Let me give you something in return. A key. It fits a door down in the east wing. Down toward the entrance they've boarded up. Use it, and you'll find yourself in the service corridor behind the shops. You'll be able to find your way out from there. Godspeed, Angel, and don't forget us in here when you're out in the world.
All I have to do is go through that door, and I'm out of here.